I'm not normally very good at showing my emotions or saying how I feel, but Lucy is genuinely the most incredible person that I know. She's so selfless, caring and loving. And I don't know anyone who's got a bad thing to say about her. She's absolutely amazing. And I can't believe she's my wife and I get to spend the rest of my life with her. I'm just so happy and incredibly lucky.
She's been a great daughter and I know she's going to be a great wife. Andrew, as she's got to know you, because it was through, I think, what she joined at university, the University Air Squadron, that you met. And we've been delighted to get to know you over the time that you two have been going out together and getting to know one another so closely. But we'll still be the same as we are.
Andrew has an incredible determination and fighting spirit and, well, an ability to get what he wants. And thank God, because he needed it with Lucy. After the third or fourth time of asking her out and getting knocked back, he persevered and Lucy decided that he wasn't just an arrogant tosser and finally gave him a chance. Sorry for the swear word, Gally. Couldn't be more made up for the both of you and wish you all the luck in the world. Finally, to the future and the rest of your lives together, which I know will be full of love, joy and happiness. It gives me immense pleasure to invite you all to stand and raise your glasses and toast to the bride and groom, to Andrew and Lucy.
Andrew and Lucy.
Well done, boss. Well done, mother.
One night to be confused, one night to speed up truth, we had a...
Lucy and I met 9.5 years ago when we were playing sport for the RAF down at Dartmouth. And as you can imagine, for Lucy, it was love at first sight. Honestly, she was texting me, hassling me, calling me. It was relentless. Oh no, wait a minute, it was the other way around. I tried all my best moves, all my best chat lines, and she wasn't interested at all. So I did what any young boy in love would do, and I asked her mate for a number.
Actually, you and Mel could go together. Ella and Kate can go together.
No, me and Mel have got something. Yeah, the fancy love with Chloe.
Chloe's just go on her own first.
But why don't you let me do
it? You said I'm
real
shy. Right, we need a drink, mate. Come on, Jack.
I've got a drink.
After that, all the hard work still laid ahead of me, and I spent a good number of months texting her, and she actually replied as well. We then had a few years of a long-distance relationship, and then when we did move closer together, I then went away to Afghanistan, followed by her going to Australia for 9 months. You know, it was a lot of tough times apart, but I think all our time apart made our time together that much more special and helped us grow as a couple. And along the way, we made so many good friends that I don't think we changed that experience for the world. As most of you know, I got quite sick last year and had to spend 3 weeks in hospital. I remember one night waking up whilst in intensive care, and I was in quite a bad way at the time, and I looked over, saw Lucy curled up on the floor with nothing more for comfort than a small cushion. I remember thinking to myself, God, when I get out of here, I'm gonna marry her. She's gonna marry her.
Wouldn't be good enough for me.
Andrew and Lucy, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
I have.
Take this ring, Andrew.
Take this ring, Andrew.
As a sign.
As a sign.
Of my love and fidelity.
Of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me kiss you, my wife.
Seeing them together is to see a team, completely equal in every way. They share the same passions and support each other and defend each other at all times. I couldn't be more made up for the both of you and wish you all the luck in the world.
And if you'll all be upstanding, please, will you raise your glasses to my incredible wife, to Lucy.